And Hollywood is one of the largest exporters of Islamophobia in the entire world. And when I talk about that in the entire world, you understand why. Understand why? Because Hollywood, not only does it affect Americans, it affects people globally. According to Motion Picture Association of America, these figures are from, I think, 2012. Hollywood claims to have 1.5 billion viewers for that year. We are now in 2015. I don't have the updated figures, but that gives you an idea about their reach. When they reach 1.5 billion people in 1 year, this number is more than 4 times the total population of the United States. So, as many of you might know, the negative stereotyping of Arabs and Muslims in Hollywood dates back to its early days. There is a very good book, I'm sure many of you have read right here, written by Jack Shaheen, called Real, R-E-E-L, Bad Arab, a book that chronicles films involving Arab and Muslim characters. In almost all films where Arabs and Muslims are characters, Hollywood has proved repeatedly to be irresponsible. It never actually changed the pattern of behavior, you know, and very violent. They always reinforcing stereotypical images and really have seldom made an effort to reflect a more objective version. And I haven't seen anything, and there are few sitcoms and whatever that sometimes they deviate from that, but in general, the images have been very stereotypical. But since the 70s, I mean, this is going back, you know, early on, you know, since the 70s and the early 80s, Hollywood has even sunk into lower levels of belligerent bias and the peddling of Islamophobia. How can they sell Islamophobia to Americans and to the rest of the world? So it's no longer the image which where they started earlier on, it's no longer the Orientalist interpretation of Arabs and Muslims, no longer the exotic, seductive image of Arab women and evil-looking, ignorant brown men on this day on the big screen. By the mid-70s, Hollywood transitioned to commissioning or purchasing entire scripts which explicitly depict Muslims as villain or terrorist. So, again, just like the examples of Islamophobia in US media, there is a dizzying number of examples of Islamophobia in Hollywood. And we can go on, just name a few films. The Wind and the Lion, 1975. Under Siege, 1986. Wanted Dead or Alive, 1987. True Lies, 1994. Homeland, series 2011, 2000, you know, up to now. World War Z, 2013. And even children movies and teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2014, and most recently, American Sniper. Let me just talk quickly about a couple of those films because, you know, for 5 minutes. So, you know, if you look at some of those films, you know, let's take for example, how many of you watched World War Z? you laugh when you watch it. It's so terrible, yeah. And it's so blatantly Islamophobic, you just can't help yourself but laugh. I mean, the whole premise of the film, where you have an Israeli army and security agencies who are portrayed as the saviors of the world and the saviors of Jerusalem, and build an apartheid wall similar to the current apartheid wall that imprisons millions of Palestinians to protect the world from these zombies. So zombies are the bad characters, so think about it. Now, you start thinking of Palestinians are the bad characters. Anyway, they get away with that. That's entertainment. Then, American Sniper, your soldiers are bellarified and Arabs and Muslims are demonized. American soldiers are presented as heroes, protectors, and even at times victims in Iraq, whereas Arabs and Muslims are all presented as militants. They don't even show you Iraqi families. The only Iraqi family they show you in the child, and they associate them with terror. So, the whole film is shot supposedly in Iraq. No Iraqis exist except this one family. And last but not least, of course, I didn't have the time to talk a bit about other things from deviating from mainstream media, but Islamophobia is disseminated on all kinds of platforms, on the web, on social media, on bus ads right here in San Francisco, and by people who claim to be men and women of faith. I don't think I have internet here, but does anyone remember Pat Robertson? You know, I mean, the most recent example.